Stephen Covey wrote a great book, Seven Habits of Successful People. This is one of the all-time bestsellers. Now here, one of the chapters says that you must find your center. You must identify it. He says, according to him, all people have one center of focus. That center influences the decisions regarding security, regarding how to be guided, regarding wisdom, as well as power. So first, spouse center. What does it mean? That the person always consults spouse for any decision regarding security, regarding if he or she has to be guided by someone, the spouse is there. Wisdom, discussion leading to what principle is right for them. So the wisdom is also based on the discussion between the spouses. Power, together they find that what should they do to acquire power, because they find power in togetherness. Each of them gives power or security to the other. So this is spouse-centered. Next, he talks about family-centered. Now, family-centered, those are the people who considers family as the foremost guiding principle. So, security, they are concerned about the security of the family, and they find security also living in the family. Their family provides them the security. They are guided by the family, by the joint decisions, by the joint discussions. Then, any wisdom, unless it is approved by the family, they will find it is not wise to do that. Power too is belonging to the family. Proves they find that if the family is together, they have the power. So they are family-centered. Next is money-centered. Money-centered is number three. The person is only concerned about money. He or she finds that all these factors, security, guidance, wisdom, power, they are all revolving around money. So anything which they acquire, if they acquire more money, so they find secure. Likewise, their wisdom is confined only to money. If they are making more money, they are wise. Likewise, they consider money is power. Of course, they want their power only through money, so therefore they are money-centered. Next, work-centered. There are also people who are only concerned about the work. Whatever work they are doing, they enjoy. Whatever work they are doing, they want to excel. Whatever work they are doing, they want to have pursuit of excellence in their work. So, because that provides them security. Work is guiding principle of their life. Wisdom, they find whatever they learn through work, with the help of their work that they are doing. So that provides them the wisdom, and that is also their power. Number five, possession centered. There are also people who keep on acquiring possessions, worldly possessions, houses, more cars, more buildings, more villas. So they are only concerned with possessions. More material possessions they have, they find that that provides them the security. That is their guiding principle. Guiding principle is how they can have more possessions, how they can acquire more possessions. They will be only on the lookout of getting deals, good deals. And their wisdom is only ability to acquire more possessions. Possessions are a power, symbol of power for them. So they are possession centered. Next we have is pleasure centered. There are persons who are only concerned with their personal pleasures, material pleasures. Whatever they do, they find pleasure. And wherever they find pleasure, they are attracted towards that. These people have absolutely no power because they have, their minds are weak and they cannot rely on their mind. They cannot stick to one job. They cannot concentrate on anything. So they are the wisdom deprived. There is no guidance and therefore they hardly have any security. 7. Friend centered. There are people who only rely on friends, on social friends, on friends in the among the colleagues, or wherever they find old friends or new friends or society. So that is their guiding principle. Because if they have more friends, they feel secure. If they have more friends, they know that somebody will guide them. If they have more friends, they can discuss and acquire wisdom that they require. And they also find power among their friends only. If their friends betray them, they feel powerless. They feel very uncomfortable. So these are the people who are friend-centered. Number 8 is enemy-centered. There are people who are only focusing on what the enemy is doing. So if they can strike the enemy, they find security. If they can defeat the enemy, if they can they consider they are the rivals, and if they can leave them behind, they find that it is a nice thing, and that is their guiding principle. Their wisdom also is confined to how they can defeat them, how they can leave their enemies behind. And their power also is restricted to if they can beat their enemies, if they can be one up from their enemies, if they can leave their enemies behind. So they find themselves powerful. Number 9 is religion centered. There are some religious people who find their security only in their religion. If they follow the principles of their religion, so they find very secure, they find very powerful. Religion only guides them. Religion only gives them, grants them the wisdom to live. And religion is their power. So they are religious people, religion centered, and they have all the concern about the religion. They have all the focus on their religion. Finally, number 10 is self-centered. Now these self-centered people are the egoists. They consider no end of themselves. They consider that they are the only right decision makers. They find the security in what they decide. They find the guidance in whatever comes to their mind. Their wisdom is confined to what they come to conclude. Their own conclusions are the only wisdom, and their power is also on their own individual actions. These are the people who don't like to rely on anyone around. So they are those people who depend on themselves, and by this, because of this, they alienate from other members of the society, whether it is their family, whether it is their workplace or society. So they are individualistic and they confine themselves.